Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to see how to handle alerts in Catalan Studio. I have this particular web page where if I click on alert, as you can see we got a normal alert. Then I click on one more, now you can see we got two, yes or no. That in this scenario we'll click on no, and now you can see we get the result in the down as cancel. Now here in this alert we have to enter something like test. I click on OK, you can see that result here. So in this tutorial we are going to automate this alerts. So let me get started here. I have taken one test case called alert demo. So I'll go to the manual mode here. I'll take this particular website, I'll paste it here. Roku apps, now you can see we have this already. Now I am launching this with the help of Chrome browser. Then there were three buttons, one for each kind of alert, where one is a normal alert, with one is a accept and deny alert, where is the one where you need to enter the data. So it loaded now. It's time to identify the objects. First object, JS alert. Second object, JS confirm. Double dot object prompt. Okay. Now you can see we got all these things properly. Then it's time to save and close this. Now what I'll do is, I already have so many here in the project repository, so I'll just create a new folder, alert demo objects. Objects means objects. Here I am saving everything. Then I'll just close it. We'll close the browser. Now it's time to start our cases. Then if you have any doubt here, you just need to go here, keyword browser, and if you built-in functions, web UI, alert, you can see all these. Alert, accept alert, dismiss, get test, set test, all those things. So first of all, let me take a browser, opening the browser. Launch the web page. This is my web page. So I'll try to maximize the window here. I'll just wait for a few seconds so that the particular web page gets loaded properly. So for that, what I'll do is, I'll just here, I'll apply thread dot sleep on. I'll just give 4 seconds of time here. Click on save, go to the manual mode. Now you can see we have this. Then click on add. Here, if you see here, I'll just close everything here. Go here. The first method that we are going to use here is verify. Here, wait for the alert. So I'll just come here. You can delete this. You can wait for the alert. Let me give it as some 10 seconds of time. Okay. Before that, in this web page, we need to click, right? So I'll apply this function called double click operation and object. So first of all, go to the objects here and see the things. Now you can see we have this object. So let me detecting methods. Let me select methods here, two ways of detecting. Come down, now once I'm done with this, close everything. In alert demo, what I need to do, first of all I need to click on it, so it will come down. So first I'll click on an object. This object is in alert demo. Here, JS alert. I'm double clicking this and I'm waiting for 10 seconds here. Then what I'll do is, I'll accept the alert. Accept the alert. Okay. So let me start executing this and show you the output. Actually it's raining here, so you might find some disturbance, guys. Now you can see started executing. It's loading the web page. and it will try to maximize now. Maximizing, then it should click on the JS alert and it should, now you can see, click down it and accept it. Now you can see you successfully clicked on the alert and it got accepted. Okay, then it's time to do the second one. Second one is JS confirm, yes or no. Here instead of accepting, I'll try to click on the cancel, that is dismiss alert. Okay, so I'll just give a delay for some time. Delay of 4 seconds I'll give here. 4 seconds I'll give. Then again you need to wait for the alert to be present, right? So wait for the alert, let's say something called 10 seconds. Okay, before the waiting, first of all we need to click on this object. So click on this object, I'll double click on it, just move up a bit and select the object. Object will be, what is the object? Object is JS confirm. So click on OK, wait for the object. Then we have dismiss the alert, right? So I'll try to use that here, yeah, dismissing it. Now let me run this and show you how dismiss will work. Now you can see I started executing this. So it will do two alerts handling. First one that we have seen before. So let's wait for the web page to load completely. It will maximize. First alert, click on JS alert, it will accept. Then it will click on the second one, JS confirm. Now you can see it clicked on the cancel, that we got the result here, right? Cool. Now what are the methods that we have? We have used accept, dismiss. Now it's time to use the get text method. Okay, so here in the get text, let me use something called, let me create variable called data. Go to the script mode. Now use here print data. You can use print ln. You can see the data here. Okay. Then our argument is sending the keys, right? So again, what I'll do is I'll apply some delay of 4 seconds. Then I'll click on this object using double click. I'm going to click prompt I have, right? So go to the object page, prompt. Here I double clicked on this object. Then I need to send the data, right? So I have set alert text method. Here I'll pass something called, let's say KB tutorials is the one I'm going to pass. Then once you set the data, what you need to do, you need to accept the alert. So create a new method called accept alert. Okay, then after this, what all are the methods remaining? Accept, dismiss, get text, set, verify alert present. Okay, so this I am going to show you now. So I'll double click on this. When I double click on it, okay, not now, maybe later I'll try to show. Delay, double click, set text, alert. Okay, so let me try to run this because I don't want to confuse you guys. How set text and also get alert text also we are seeing here. Even that I'll show you it on the console. So let it load properly. Maximize it. Clicks on the first one using accept alert. Clicks on the second one. It will be like a wait delay and clicked on a cancel prompt will enter. Now you can see whatever it entered correctly. Okay, so these are the things. Only one thing that I'll want to show you. Here there is some method called this one, verify alert present, verify alert not present. So I'll just show you for this one. I'll show it in the first one itself. Wait for the alert. Okay, here it will return true or false, guys. It's a boolean variable, so it's asking for how many seconds you want to wait before it throwing true or false. Okay, here this one, let me keep it as flag now. That get test we can see here. Now you can see this is a get test one function. Get text, get alert test. This is a one. Okay. Then this flag, I have it in the flag variable, right? So I'll just try to show println of flag. So it will just show you whether the alert is presented or not. If it is presented, it will return true. If not presented, it will return false. Okay, so I started executing now. Let's see how the output comes. So now you can see it is started loading. Double clicked. Wait for 4 seconds, then click on the confirm where I am using dismiss, and the click on JS prompt where I am using send case. Okay, means set text. Now if you go here to the console, this is the one JS confirm using the get text method. Print. Now you can see get alert text. I have printing that here, and in the beginning the print flag, that is true. Okay. If it is not there, it will return false, guys. So I hope it's informative for you guys. If you have any doubt, let me know in the comment section so that I can help you more on this. Thank you so much.